Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to the Tribe of the Tides, where in the last episode, Koreme began showing off the very first signs of a strange and mysterious illness that she picked up from the leeches in the water. Technically, she has been infected by a glitch, which causes her to take damage every single day that we pass, despite the fact that we already took the leech off of her. So unfortunately, her life is literally going to be cut in half because she loses a day of it every single day that we pass. So she had to start a family as soon as possible, and Echo was looking to start a family too, since he is the king of the seas, and of course he needs some suitable heirs to take the throne when he passes away. So he is currently starting a little family. He has a daughter already, which I actually wanted to change the name of. I'm going to call her Marina, because I thought that would be a pretty good seaworthy name for her. She looks almost exactly like her mother too, which is absolutely adorable. She just has those very vivid horns, of course, and some paler fur, I think. Yeah, two slots of gray fur, but she is absolutely adorable. So Marina is her name, and they're going to have one more baby together before Echo actually goes off to take care of his duties. I was thinking he would probably go back here with his mother to see if they could fish up anything out of this river. I don't think they have a high enough fishing skill to pick up this little orange fish over here. I believe they actually need the fishing tail before they can do that. So hopefully in this episode we'll be able to finally get the fishing tail as well. We do have it in our mutation menu right now along with the water body, so that hopefully her baby will have the water body too. Some sort of way of not only breathing underwater, but also catching the fish a little bit more easily. Though Dewdrop, poor little Dewdrop back here, is watching very, very mournfully from a distance as she creates her own little family with Echo, because I feel like he definitely was hoping that they could start a family together, and maybe when Echo goes off to do his own duties, maybe Dewdrop will sneak in just to see how Koreme is doing now. And then of course we have her brother back here, Cinder, her half-brother technically, who I think is probably going to be starting a family with Isla pretty soon. They've kind of been watching each other from behind this tree, so I feel like if they can find a nest out here somewhere, maybe they will start a little family of their own. And then of course we have the Crackerjaw baby, who will probably be joining them by the tree, just because he's one of the very few creatures who can pick up the acorns that fall underneath there. And actually, these babies might be unprotected right now. I just realized we need an adult to stand in the middle of them, but it looks like the bird is actually out of our skies right now, so I guess they'll be fine for this turn, but we definitely need somebody to come down here in the next turn. And in fact, Misty might be the one. She could probably sit right here with all of her babies, because most of these children are actually hers. Believe it or not, Misty has had a lot of babies in her short time on this island so far. She was actually starting a family with Canuvon because he has the nimble fingers, so hopefully they'll be having at least one more baby in this episode. And then the traditionalists over here, the poor traditionalists, which are down to just four, are actually going to be moving off in this episode too. So Komeko has fully grown. She is ready to take on her duty as the leader of the traditionalists, and she's actually going to start taking them down the shore so that they can hopefully scout out the area toward the back of the island. I'm hoping that there's going to be more berry bushes here in particular, because of course that is their main source of food, and they only have this one lonely berry bush to pick from right now, which only has one berry on it, in fact. So Eclipse, why don't you go ahead and pick up that berry for us? So there we go. It looked like there were two on there. I only saw the one. His daughter, thankfully, Honey, did finally inherit those nimble fingers. So she at least has them in her genetics, and that means that we can continue on the nimble fingered line, hopefully. I mean, we have struggled to pass those along so far, so fingers crossed that it's a little bit easier this time. Duke Meme, of course, did pass away, but he gave the throne to Nuku, his son, and he is looking very kingly, even though he's just a little tiny child. He is looking very kingly atop his throne. We have Summer over here, who kind of snuck her way in from the traditionalists because she wasn't really interested in their ways anymore. But as it is, she is currently using all of their bunny traps to a snack from. So we'll have to see if she continues doing that in this episode. And we have something back here rustling, don't we? This might just be another bunny, but I am going to be cautious and take a look, just because we did have that situation with Jasper and Ilair back here. They were desperately trying to find a nest to start their own family, and they ended up running into a carnivore, but because they're both beasts, they did just fine. Now let's see what this is. Just a bunny. Okay, so there is definitely some sort of a burrow back here. Thankfully, Taronu has been doing a very good job chasing after these bunnies. I'm not sure if he's actually caught any yet, but he's doing a good job chasing them at the very least, so they shouldn't be snacking on any of their food. Now, let's see. I think we want Komeko and Birch to actually start making their way down the shore now. They're going to be leaving Eclipse and Honey behind for a little while, just because Honey isn't fully grown yet, so I don't want her getting picked off by the bird. But Birch has 2 gems, so he should be safe. And of course, Komeko is going to be right alongside him anyway, so if they run into any dangers out there, then they should be able to take them on at least together. So we'll move them both down the shore. They're going to keep a wide path around the carnivores' territory, of course, because they are not too interested in their ways. They're kind of, it's like an old feud almost between Sira and Duke Meme. So if they stay right there for this turn, they should be fine. I'm pretty sure Birch will be fine, even though he's a little bit in the water. Since he's younger, there is a possibility that he could drown if we put him a little bit too deep, but I think he'll be fine right there. And then, Honey, I suppose you could move on this side of your father, just to light up the area a little bit more for us. And then Splish, unfortunately, this is Splish's last turn, his very last turn, so he is actually going to sink into the water over here, and maybe just, like, swim upstream a little bit, see if he can find anything. Unfortunately, these places were empty, but at least he'll be able to pass some in his natural habitat with his gills underwater, so he should be very, very happy. And let's see, unfortunately Dawn is also passing away on this turn. This is her very last turn. She's sitting next to her last son though, so they can spend a little bit of time together. Bolt has to stay by him too. We'll actually move him right here, just so that he can actually protect the baby when she passes away. We'll probably move him up toward his brothers and sisters here in a moment once he has an extra turn. But otherwise, I think we might be just about done for this turn. We have Cinder back here though. We have Cinder and Isla who can at least pick some berries. We'll pick this little shriveled up berry, and then we'll pick these two. And then we probably actually want her to start expanding the territory, because if we're going to have the Crackerjaw baby come up here, then we do want to make sure that he's not going to get ambushed by any predators. So why don't we actually have you scoot right up here right now, just like double check though that the bird is not in our skies. Yeah, the bird is definitely not here right now. I do not see it. So these babies should be safe, like fingers crossed. We'll bring Riptide right over here to pick up some of the acorns. So that should at least give us some extra food too, because we are kind of getting a little bit low since we had so much trouble with those nimble fingers. We haven't been able to collect the shells or the acorns or the berries in an effective way, but it should be easier now. And then last but not least, I think we just have Dewdrop back here to do something with. So let's have him, he would want to stay in the area because I do feel like once Echo leaves, he might sneak in there to see Koreme. And I did see a bunny down there, didn't I? Like, these are the bunnies' tide pools, I feel like. They are just hopping around looking for shells. I guess we could leave Dewdrop right here. Yeah, there's the bunny, just in case it comes hopping a little bit too close. But let's go ahead and skip the turn now and hope that the bird doesn't come out. I did hear a little bit of noise. Oh my goodness, that was the noise that I heard. Oh, that is not good. As soon as they have their baby too, they have to protect their baby at the very least. Okay, so let's actually move Misty right here first, just in case any bird situations pop up in the meantime. We'll move Misty right in the middle of all the babies, and then we'll scoot right back up here to see what's going on. So what little baby did you guys have? Oh my gosh, how fitting is this? How fitting is this that they managed to have one with the double claws? Because, of course, they are a family of beasts. And, oh my gosh, she actually mutated the fishing tail, too, that we were trying to get on our water baby family. Oh, that is so cool. So that means that she might be able to scoot along this little stream and see if she can find any fish to catch if she survives this. If she survives, because this carnivore is kind of looming over them at the moment. So let's have Ilair smack him as many times as she can. And then he only has 3 days left, so we are perfectly fine. We can just scoot right over here, we can slap him again, and there we go. We can pick up the meat. And it looks like we also have a little tree stump over here too, so that's excellent. That's going to make it so we can see a little bit further around this territory. So they have found like a pretty good spot to settle down, all things considered. They have found a very, very good spot. But let's see what this little baby is like as well. Let's see, did you manage to inherit the water body? It doesn't really look like it, unfortunately. Yeah, just in his genetics, so hopefully we're going to be able to pull that out later, but right now it is not the case. Now let's see, he has normal eyes, thankfully, he has the normal blood clotting, he does have one gene of hemophilia, so we will keep an eye on that, but he is adorable! So let's change his name over to a Cove. His name will be Cove, so we have Cove and Marina for this little family so far, and somebody needs to pick up this crabbit meat too. We need to pick up the carnivore meat, of course. That's very important. And then I guess Knuvan probably wants to go right back to his berry bushes. We'll pick from this one for now, and then we'll move him between them in the next turn. And yeah, the crabbit meat. Who is going to pick up the crabbit meat, I wonder? I mean, I guess some Echo could. You could scoot over here, you can pick up this meat, and then I want you to scoot around this way so that you can help your mother fish a little bit, because you might be able to chase these fish in between both of you, couldn't you? I mean, it was scooting away from him, so maybe on the next turn they can do that. For now, we could have Coral kind of set herself up a little bit better. Actually, I think the fish just scooted right in front of her, didn't it? I'm pretty sure this is the fishing icon, so let's go ahead and click this. There we go, so we did manage to take one fish. I mean, unfortunately, it doesn't seem like the fishing really gives us enough food to sustain ourselves with, so I don't know how much fishing we're actually going to be doing in the future, but Riptide, you can at least gather up the acorns because that is going to be a huge help to maintain our food supplies. And then Isla and Cinder. Let's see, if we had somebody else to pick up these berries, that would probably be a better idea, because unfortunately Cinder only collects one berry a turn, so he's not exactly the best candidate for that. I mean, we'll just move him up here for now, we'll peek in the grass a little bit to spread the area out and make sure that Riptide is safe, and then Isla can help you, of course. And then Dewdrop and Koreme. Well, thankfully Kareem's babies are safe, so maybe Koreme could actually scoot out here to talk to Dewdrop herself. She could set up right next to him and they can have a nice long chat. He was probably very, very worried about her after all. He was the one who saved her way off in the water from the leech initially, but unfortunately at the time they were not aware that she had picked up this disease from the leech. So they'll stay there for now, and then let's see, Misty, we want you to stay there as well, and then Wave, we want to change your gem over to blue because you of course were born in the water baby pack. I do need to remember to change their gems over. So since Wave has his second gem, he could scoot up here and grab a couple of these berries for us, since he can at least grab one. And then we want these guys to start making their way down the shore because look at that, Honey has her second gem already. Excellent. So why don't you pick up your berries for the final time? And in fact, we could have Honey pick the berries this time because this is like her first experience picking berries, isn't it? And then we'll scoot her along the shore. We'll scoot Eclipse after her after he picks up the shell. There we go. We want the shell first and then they can sit next to each other. So they're going to make their slow way over to where Komeko is. Eventually they will catch up. It looks like he has 6 days left of his life, so hopefully it won't take too long for him to get up to them. We don't want him passing away before they find a place to settle down back here. But Bolt. Let's see, we have Bolt up here. Unfortunately, yeah, Dawn did pass away. So let's have Kurtavan come over here by his siblings, just to keep him safe, because it looks like Cease has actually grown up too. Nuku still has a couple more days before he's ready to take on his very final gem and officially become the king of the island. I mean, he is the king of the island now, but he's just a little baby, so I mean, I don't know how much leading he's really doing at this point. But Bolt, I mean, it's your very final day too, and I feel like he probably misses his brother. Jasper was his brother, and he didn't really get to say goodbye to him either. I mean, he kind of just disappeared on him one day. He went off to go start a family with Ilaire without telling him very much, so maybe he would scoot out this way and he would run into Komeko, and honestly, I mean, we could try having a baby with them because their immunity genes line up very, very well, much better than many of the other pairings that we currently have on this island. So why don't we have them breed? We'll have them breed before they continue scooting along the shore over here, and this is going to be a little bit of a shocker for the traditionalist side of the family, of course, that she's breeding with somebody from the carnivore line. So I'm sure if anyone finds out, they are not going to be too happy with her. For now though, she will continue moving this way, she'll go along the beach, and then Birch can kind of catch up behind her, and they can sit here with all of the crabbits, of course. Now Summer is still over here munching away at this one little berry bush, so she can pick a couple of berries with her last few turns. And then Cease, we're going to actually keep you right there to keep the baby safe, and of course Nuku is sitting right on top of his throne. And then it looks like Taronu, you have a little friend back here, don't you? You found a little crabbit friend, oh my gosh. Okay, so I think the crabbit must have crawled out of the water over here to come say hi to him. This poor guy though, he is like stranded in the swamp right now, isn't he? Chasing his bunnies all the way up to practically where Ilaire and Jasper are. So maybe he'll continue moving along this way, like past the crabbit, just quietly scoot past the crabbit, and then I guess he's going to run into these guys. So that'll be interesting to see how he can help out their pack. He could at least clear out the area for them, and then of course we have Dewdrop and Koreme over here who are still chatting away, and I feel like maybe Dewdrop is going to suggest that they also run off into the grass somewhere and try to find their own place to settle down and start a family. So as I'm sure many of you knew was coming, Dewdrop is actually going to have a baby with Koreme as well, and I think they are going to hightail it straight out of here before Echo comes back. So Koreme is going to go this way back where her brother is, and maybe she'll tell him where she's going, because I'm sure he would be very concerned, and then Dewdrop will have to catch up this way. You know, Dewdrop is actually not really fully blood related to Echo either, so I feel like he sort of feels like an outcast at this point anyway. He was actually the son of Splash the Second and Coral. They had a baby right before they left for the new island, so he is a bit of an outcast as it is, so I feel like it's probably quite fitting for him to want to leave this area, even beyond all of the drama with the babies. But Misty needs to stay right here to protect all of these little tiny critters, and I think other than that, we are done with our turns. So let's see, there's no babies being born on this turn, right? I don't think anyone is on the nest, so let's just skip the day and hope that nothing is going to jump out and attack us. I do see something back here, so we probably do want to check that out. Thankfully, it is raining though, and you guys haven't left yet, so you can actually scoop up these berries as fast as you can. There we go, just for that little bit of extra food, of course. And then Honey could actually pick up the shell, so you guys are learning how to collect shells in the meantime too. We'll move Honey right next to her father, and they can pick up both of those shells in the next turn, as long as they're still there. And then poor Bolt. Poor Bolt also passed away, but at least he's going to have one baby. He'll have one baby with Komeko, as long as they can find a nest. And then Birchum can actually start carving his own path up here. Oh my goodness! Okay, let's grab the bunny, and let's grab up the meat. They don't mind the bunny meat, because of course Adam and Eve always ate bunnies too, but they do prefer the berries. So we'll peek at this bush, and we'll pick up a couple of the berries, as many as we possibly can before we have to move out. And then you can grab your second gem, it looks like, so he can actually scoot out a little bit further to light up the area. That would probably be a good idea just to keep the area safe. And for that matter, since these guys are moving out, they could actually take control of this area of the island again. They could take control of the bunny burrow in particular, because of course they definitely want to munch on some of those bunnies. Let's have Cease move down here just in case any of the bunnies are hopping around, because we do know that they like to come down to these tide pools. So we'll have her sit there for now. We'll have Summer pick up these berries, because she is probably very, very happy with the rain at the moment. And then, of course, we need to have Koreme and Dewdrop start making their way into the grass. So I guess they'll just cut straight up here, and maybe they'll also end up where Jasper and Ilaire are. Maybe that is exactly where they're going. So we'll have Cinder start clearing out the way for her, because I'm sure he would be very supportive. All things considered, he would want her to be happy. So we could have Dewdrop move up here, and then they can start playing leapfrog past the rock. We'll have him go up this way, and then she can follow him. They're not going to worry about clearing a path just yet, because I'm sure they don't want anyone to follow them. They did find a bunny burrow though, right next to the water. That is like a terrible spot to build a bunny burrow, honestly. We have some rustling back here, but that's probably the bunny from the bunny burrow. And there's Splish too. Poor Splish, who passed away a couple turns ago. He's still in the water, so at least he was happy when he passed. And then we want Canuvon to come over here and pick his berries as well. There we go. Now Echo, let's see if you can actually chase some of the fish toward your mother. You actually could pick these up yourself. All right. And then we could have Coral come over here, and you guys can like trap the fish in between both of you. Look at that. That's an excellent way to do it. And it looks like this fish might actually be dead. I think so. So we can actually harvest this right now. There we go. That gave us four pieces of food, I think. Now, do we have the bird in our skies yet? I don't think the bird has spawned just yet. So let's actually have Misty come down here to breed with Canuvon so that she can have another baby with possibly the Nimble Fingers. We'll go ahead and swap this around a little bit. The Nimble Fingers there. And let's go ahead and place the water body in the 10% slot for now, just so we hopefully don't lose that on our babies. And then we'll have, let's see, Cove can move right here, and then Misty can scoot right back into the nest. I think Marina will be fine being right next to River, but just in case, we'll move Marina over here so that no birds come down and scoop her away. And then we want, of course, Riptide to, I guess he could scoot over this way to pick up the acorns instead. Though if we placed him maybe on one of these tiles, that might be a little bit more effective, because as it is, acorns can't really fall right where the berry bush is, so it wouldn't do him any good to sit right there. Now instead, we'll have you guys continue clearing out the path, I suppose. You can expand the territory as usual. Pretty soon they will have to have a baby because Isla only has 11 days left of her life. So they'll have to start their adorable little family too. But for now, Cinder, oh my goodness, you can find another berry bush for us. Excellent. I mean, how many berry bushes do we have over here now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 berry bushes in this tiny little spot. Like, you guys must be kicking yourselves right now. You probably wished you came over here instead with all of these berries. But let's have Isla go ahead and clear out the grass this way. She can come over here by the water and just peek in the grass for us. And then Wave, you can actually scoot up this way instead to clear out the grass by the tree for your brother. And now River, I guess we could move you up this way too. She has a very, very wide range, thankfully, because of those two running legs. And also because of those two running legs, we could sit her by the berry bush to collect some berries for us, because she could pick up 2 berries per turn instead of the usual 1. But other than that, we just have these guys way back here to deal with. And in fact, I think we probably want them to breed again because Jasper is getting quite old now. He's getting quite old. So why don't you go ahead and peek over here? But oh my goodness, did I just see a little bunny scoot behind you? Look at that, Taronu. Finally! Finally, you can grab one of these pesky little bunnies. He has been trying to do that for so long now. Let's have him peek in the grass. There is something over here too. So yeah, let's have Jasper jump up here just to get a better look. I still don't see it though. Okay, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. That is a lot of rustling. Jasper, that may have not been the best idea. We have so much rustling grass over here. Oh my gosh. Well, Ilair, come over here to breed with him, please. He can use his turn to actually breed with you. And then we'll have the baby. Oh my goodness, we'll have the baby sit right here, I guess, and then she can sit in the nest just to continue expanding their family, especially if there is a problem with all of this rustling grass. Like, a lot of them are moving too, which is a little bit worrying. Thankfully, most of the females are protected in this area just in case they're wandering males. Like, again, I don't think we've actually had a run-in with any wandering males on this entire island, so we'll have to keep a very close eye on that side of the pack. And it looks like, Nuku, you will be growing up in the next turn, so you can finally take on your next gem as soon as we skip the day, and I think that might happen right now. So let's go ahead and skip, and keep an eye on all of this grass. Okay, like, I don't see anything just yet, but we did actually get a new mutation, the Toxic Body. The Toxic Body. Do we have the Toxic Body on one of these babies? Or did we just explore enough of those swamp tiles? Let's see. So Dooknoo only has the normal body, but look at that. The blue eyes with the white tiger stripes. Oh my gosh, that is gorgeous. It's kind of hard to see around all of this grass, but I'm worried about using their turns since we don't know what's in the grass right now. I might actually leave them with all of their turns for now, just in case. But yeah, Dooknoo. Okay, so he has normal blood clotting and normal eyes. All right, he has like those perfect genetics aside from his no paw. He did inherit his father's no paw, so we'll have to keep that in mind. But let's see what the other baby looks like too. Let's see, way back here. Oh my gosh, yes! The cracker jaw and... what? The cracker jaw and double nimble fingers? How did that even happen? Oh my gosh, this is like the ultimate collecting male in the pack right now. This guy is crazy. Vankir, okay. Okay, we're going to have to find a good name for you too. Like, if you guys have any ideas for a name for this guy, this ultimate collector, then let me know. And we'll go ahead and name him in the next episode. Oh my gosh, that is crazy. We have not seen a creature with the double nimble fingers in so long. I'm not sure if we've ever had one on any of our islands. So that is perfect. I feel like if these guys got wind of that, then they would definitely want to go see that baby too. They would definitely want to go see that baby on the other side of the island, though it would be a long trek for them in all honesty. Now Eclipse, why don't you pick up the shells for your little daughter, and then you can scoot along the shore this way. He only has 4 days left of his life too, so I'm getting a little bit concerned that it might be hard for them to catch up to these guys up here. And they have a little audience of crabbits watching them gather berries. Look at this. That is actually adorable. Okay, so the crabbits are apparently following them to their new land. I guess we'll just continue scooting them along this way because it's a little bit more important that we find, aha, a nest. Yes, that is perfect. Okay, so let's move her straight to the nest. And then we actually want to shuffle around the mutation menu now for her baby, because I was hoping that the poison fangs would stay in her line. So just in case that gives us a little bit of a boost in keeping the poison fangs, we're going to put it right there. And then I believe we also want to put the normal eyes in here, because if I remember correctly, Bolt had the short-sighted trait on him. So just in case, because she also has a short-sighted eyes in her genetics. So let's peek in some of this grass right here, and then Birch can do so as well, just to keep his sister safe. And then for now, they will settle down right there, and they'll wait for Honey and Eclipse to catch up to pick from the berry bush. And then let's see, where should we go next? I'm starting to wonder if maybe Nuku and Summer should have a baby, because they're both right nearby, and I believe their immunity genes also line up very well. Yeah, they do, so that is a possibility. I don't want their line to become a full of no paws, of course. So maybe if we place like the claw in the mutation menu instead, then hopefully we'll end up with a situation like this little one back here with the cracker jaw, and they can still have the double claws if we mutate it correctly. But for now, let's have Cece come up here and help her brother clear out some of the grass. We should probably sit her right here just so that she can see the bunnies when they spawn, and she is probably watching very, very closely to make sure that these guys don't get too close to their territory anyway. They could have been watching a little bit more closely with this situation over here, but fingers crossed that we end up with a good baby out of that one. Now, how is it going with all the rustling grass back here? How is this situation? Like, we do need to keep the babies safe, so Ilaire, why don't you sit right here so you're between two of your babies? And then Jasper, why don't you explore a little bit? I mean, I hate to make the area so dark because he's not on the stump. And actually, wait a second, his baby could sit on top of this stump instead, so she could light up the area for him while he goes to investigate. Yeah, there's so much rustling grass over here, it's crazy. Let's move him this way, because we are probably going to meet up with Koreme and Dewdrop anyway. So let's have Koreme peek at the bunny burrow so we know it's there. And then let's start playing leapfrog again. Aha, bunnies, so many bunnies. Okay, that is a lot better than the alternative, of course. Now let's see, she has 5 days left of her life. Oh my gosh, is she going to be able to make it to the nest in time? Let's move her a little bit closer. Yeah, that is really cutting it close. I mean, if we clear out the area a little bit more, there is a better possibility that she might be able to make it there. And let's have Taronu come in from the other side. Like, these guys are probably so concerned right now. Not only do they have all of this rustling grass out in the wilderness, but then Taronu just kind of like stumbles into their territory with his two double claws just waving away at them. And then Dewdrop and Koreme are going to be quite the same, stumbling in from the opposite side. So Dewdrop, why don't you come up here so that she'll have a better chance of getting to the nest? And I think she might actually make it. She does have a pretty decent speed, so if she goes over here on the next turn, then she might be able to make it straight to the nest, and then we're going to have to cross our fingers that she'll have enough left in her to actually have her baby before she passes away. That is the main concern, because if their life is over on the same day that they're giving birth, then the baby will not be born. So we're going to have to keep a very close eye on that. But for now, let's change some of these gems over to blue, because you guys definitely need your little blue gems. There we go. And then Riptide, you are actually fully grown now. Look at you. He is definitely going to have to start a little family too. Like, he is just the most adorable little cracker jaw I've ever seen, with his sunken in eyes from the panda patterns. Let's actually have you pick the berries for now, because that's probably a little bit more important since it is raining. And then River can do the same. There we go. And then Isla and Cinder. Let's see, you guys were still going to peer in all of this grass for us. There we go. You can come over here and look in that grass too on the next turn. And then you might as well pick up some of the berries as well. And then we just have, of course, Misty over here with her ultimate collector baby. So why don't we leave you right there? We could actually move you, well, we could move you right here so that you're still protecting the babies. And then Canuvon, go ahead and gather up your berries. You have done your job, thankfully. You have completed your mission of having a baby with the nimble fingers. You have done a very good job. And actually, that means that we are guaranteed to have nimble-fingered babies if we breed Vankyr in the future, because he has the double nimble fingers. So this is absolutely perfect. This is perfect for us. Now, Echo, how is the fishing going with your mother? I think your mother, oh my gosh, she's going to pass away. Oh, that is so sad. At least they're together, though. At least there's that. And you do have a little fish to collect over here, it looks like. Yeah, this is actually a pretty good spot to set up a fishing point. If we had somebody with the fishing tail to sit here on this side of the island, then this would be perfect because they could just sit here and have a couple of spaces to hopefully grab a fish. Or even right here instead. This might have been even better right here, because then they would have three possible tiles to collect fish from. But let's have Coral use up her last couple of turns to spread out the territory a little bit. At least she's going to be with Echo, of course, when she passes away. And I think we might be just about done with all of our turns. Let's just have Marina pick up a couple more berries, and then Wave can actually help her out. And then we are done over here because we need to keep the babies safe. And I'm pretty sure everyone else is all tired out. So let's go ahead and skip the turn, and we'll zoom in on little Komeko so we can see what her baby's going to look like. Let's see, poison fangs? No, the cracker jaw! The cracker jaw of all things! Okay, well, You know, Bolt was actually the son of, I believe, Crystal, if I remember correctly. I'm not sure if they're still going to be on here, because they do technically get removed once all of their babies have passed away, except for Adam. Adam likes to haunt our family tree for some reason. Like, it's just a glitch. I know it's just a glitch, but it's kind of amusing that he's always here every single time I open up the family tree. But yeah, we have Crystal, we have Quartz, and I believe Bolt was actually the son of Crystal, right? Let's see, Bolt. Unfortunately, it kind of, like, took away his, family because he already passed away. But yeah, I'm pretty sure because, Jasper was, of course, his brother. So they were both born from Crystal, and Crystal had that lovely cracker jaw on her. She was the daughter of Speck and Sienna, of course, the, very beloved Speck and Sienna. And we have some rustling grass over here, too, that we should probably take a look at. So let's have Birch jump in here. Okay, those pesky bunnies. They're trying to scare me. Those pesky, pesky bunnies. We'll have Komeko come over here to, spread out the territory a little bit more, too, just to, keep her baby safe, because I'm sure that is a top priority right now. And then we'll have you guys start making your way again down the shore. We'll have you guys kind of play leapfrog, actually. It looks like Honey is fully grown too, so we should actually be able to make it straight over to the berry bush. There we go. So they're at the berry bush and a dead crabbit. Okay. Let's have Honey pick up some of the shells for now since she's right next to them. Yeah, so we're doing pretty good with the food situation now that we have all of these nimble fingers and cracker jaws to play around with. And poor Coral. Oh, poor Coral, you passed away. At least you were with your son. I think at this point Echo would probably start returning, but of course he's going to be very surprised to find that his mate is no longer in the pack. She has completely disappeared and left her two children behind, so he's probably very, very confused right now and very concerned, but they are so far away, way off in the grass, that there's no way that he would be able to find them. So for now, you guys are going to have to shuffle around, actually. She has 4 days left, okay. So she should have enough time to actually have her baby. Let's have Dooknoo move over here. Oh my goodness, to find this thing. He actually found the healing plant. How perfect is that? Oh my gosh, this is excellent. So wait a second, we could actually have Koreme come over here and heal herself if we play this right. She needs to use her turns to come over here. Yeah, so instead of giving birth on this turn, she could come over here and actually pick the fruit and heal herself of all of the damage that she took from that disease. Oh my gosh, let's have her do that. She can come over here, she can pick up the fruit, and there we go. She has 9 days left on her lifespan now. How utterly perfect was it that this little baby managed to find that plant in the nick of time? Let's have Taronu clear out the grass too so that she's not sitting right in the middle of all this tall grass. Oh my gosh, she must be so thankful right now too that he actually managed to find that. And that means on the next turn, she can have her baby without worrying about possibly losing it when she passes away herself. So honestly, we do need to find little names for these babies too. And since they're part of the line that had all of the gem-related names, I would like to give them some gem names themselves. So let's see, this little baby right here with her fishing tail, what should we name her? I feel like Pearl would actually be a good name for her because she's going to be spending a lot of time by the water anyway to hopefully collect some fish. Her fishing skill is a 4, oh my gosh. So she could basically pick up any of the fish in the water if she wanted to. So yeah, we have little Pearl over here, And then this little baby too, the savior of Koreme. Let's actually name him Diamond. We'll go ahead and name him Diamond because he is a very, very lucky little baby. Okay, so let's have you guys actually start exploring the area a little bit more because there is still a lot of rustling grass out here. So Jasper, why don't you scoot over this way and try to figure out what's in here? Aha, the bunnies. Okay, so you guys are going to be feasting back here too on top of it all. Let's have Dewdrop actually clear out the grass as well and find some berry bushes. Okay, that's always good to see. This little baby is protected, so we could have Ilaire come over here to pick up these berries for us. That's probably why there is so much rustling grass, because we have the berry bushes over here that the bunnies are taking a peek at. But we'll have Taronu come over this way, just to make sure that everyone is well protected, because he's our strongest pack member at the moment. And then we'll leave little Pearl right on top of the stump for now, just so that she can light up the area a little bit more. But there we go, that is excellent. So in the next episode, we'll have Koreme finally scoot over to this nest to have her baby. I am so happy that she managed to heal herself, but at least she can rest easy knowing that she can still have her baby. And for that matter, maybe they can have another baby too. Maybe they'll actually be able to have more than one baby together. Little Koreme and Dewdrop, who had such a bond from the beginning, and it has been so fun to watch their story unfold. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you all so much for watching today, and I will see you all next time. Bye guys!